وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم.
كاليفورنيا and embraced Islam in 1989.
الحمد لله. الحمد لله رب العالمين. حمدا يوافي نعمه ويكافي مزيده. يا ربي لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك ولعظيم سلطانك. O our Lord, praise is yours as befits the magnificence of your countenance and the greatness of your power. سبحانك لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك. Glory to you. We cannot praise you as you have praised yourself. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send peace and blessings upon our Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Allahumma salli wa sallam ala Sayyidina Muhammadin nuri kasari wa madari kaljari wa jma'na bihi fi kulli atwarina wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ya nur wa alayna ma'ahum wa fihim bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. And we ask Allah that these prayers be upon us with them and among them with the Prophet and his companions and his family by his mercy, and he's the most merciful of the merciful. And alhamdulillah, by the blessing of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah's mercy and Allah's blessing, ni'matullah wa in ta'uddu ni'matullahi la tuhsuha. And were you to attempt to count Allah's blessing, you could not encompass it. Sahl bin Abdullah at-Tustari said that this ni'mah, ni'matullah in this verse is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. By that, we were led to and shown how to be in Allah's presence, how to be with Allah, how to mention Allah, how to be remembered by Allah, how to be remembered among a company better than this, how to be surrounded by angels, how to have angelic reports of this gathering taken to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how to be given all that we ask here and given refuge from all from that we seek refuge from, and to be forgiven all of us, even those who are heedless. Allah says, as the Prophet ﷺ reported in the Sahih Hadith of Bukhari and Muslim, أَنَا عِنْدَ ظَنِّ عَبْدِي بِي وَأَنَا مَعَهُ إِذَا ذَكَرَنِي. I am as my servant believes me to be, or I am with the good opinion my servant has of me, and I am with him when he remembers me. So he came and taught us how to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِذَا ذَكَرَنِي فِي نَفْسِي ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي نَفْسِي. When he remembers me within himself, I remember him with myself. وَإِذَا ذَكَرَنِي فِي مَلَئٍ ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي مَلَئٍ خَيْرٍ مِّنْهُمْ. And if he mentions me, remembers me in a gathering, I remember him in a group gathering better than them. And we ask Allah to open for us, by the blessing of the one who emerged in this month, a door between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's remembrance, by which meanings of his attributes, names, and ultimately his essence reflect in our hearts and are reflected in our deeds. And this is the mission of humanity, of the children of Adam, of the prophets and messengers and their followers on the surface of this earth, to reflect the names of this one who we're remembering, this one who's remembering us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. Remember when, Allah says. And when, meaning remember when, O Muhammad, Allah said to the angels, your Lord said, verily I am placing a vicegerent, a representative of who? Of Allah, upon the earth. And there's a point to which we will return, insha'Allah ta'ala, and we ask Allah to bless us in this and bless us in our time. That khilafah was on the earth, not in the sama', not in the heavens. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created our father Adam, and prior to his life, created the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or actually prior to his life of Adam, informed us of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his light having been the first creation of Allah. He was asked, when were you a prophet? And he said, well, Adam was between the spirit and the body. Well, Adam bain al-ruhi wal-jasad. And Allah imbued the earth from which Adam would be brought to life with the light of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. So when he was created, that light shone in his forehead, and that was the thing to which the angels were commanded to prostrate. And Adam, in his earthly life, his celestial life, and then placed on earth, was a caliph of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a representative of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as were all of the prophets and messengers. And he bore that light of the Prophet Muhammad salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi, which descended with him to this earth, as he said, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And that light was passed on to Seth, and then through his descendants, among them prophets, until it reached Nuh alayhi salam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us that I rode the ark with Nuh, and his light was cast into the fire in the loins of Ibrahim, as he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, until that trust eventually reached his father Abdullah and was passed to his mother Amina, and he, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, in his beauty and perfection and magnificence, in his meaning and his spirit, as well as his physical form, emerged into this realm, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, and demonstrated, lived, transmitted, personified this meaning of khilafa, this meaning of this gerency of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to an extent that no creature has or will ever transmit. And upon the realization of the sharia which he established and ultimately sealed will be the qiyamah, the resurrection, and we will learn deep meanings about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that could only manifest as the result of, or will only manifest as a result of, the outcomes of our obedience to the sharia of Muhammad or disobedience thereto. And he described his mission, as Shaykh Ibrahim mentioned, Hafidhullah wa nafa'ana bihi, as innama bu'ithtu li'utammima makaram al-akhlaq. Verily I was only sent to perfect noble character, to perfect pious character, pious noble morals. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described humanity's creation and his placement in this earth, ja'ilun fil ardi khalifa. I am placing a vicegerent on the surface of this earth. And that is our mission, and his mission was character, so there must be a connection between character and this vicegerency, and particularly that of the person of the Prophet Muhammad salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi. So let us then look, and in detail, Shaykh Ibrahim mentioned the character of Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or in some of its detail and some of its examples. And in general, Sayyidina Aisha radiyallahu anha wa ardaha, that great faqiha, that great woman of deep understanding of the religion, that great knower of Allah, that great siddiqa, bint as-siddiq, that woman of veracity, son of the daughter of the veracious, Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, when asked about the character of Allah's messenger, when the tabi'een said, Ya ummal mu'mineen, anbi'ini an akhlaqi Rasulillah. O mother of believers, mother of the faithful, tell us about the character of Allah's messenger. She said, don't you recite the Qur'an. She pointed us to a deep meaning beyond the phrase that she expressed in her modesty and complete adab with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the questioner said, of course, she said, فَإِنَّ خُلُقَ نَبِيَ اللَّهِ كَانَ الْقُرْآنِ. Verily, the character of God's Prophet was the Qur'an. The character of God's Prophet was the Qur'an, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. A great knower of Allah, Al-Arif As-Suhrawardi, he mentions in his book, Awarif Al-Ma'arif, that she showed absolute adab and total modesty with the divine presence, and mentioned, as the knowers of God often do by allusion, a deep obscure meaning about God's Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. So it's as if she said to us, and the Quran, what is the Quran? The Quran is kalamullah. The Quran is a speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is one of his beginningless eternal attributes. It's as if she said, كَانَ مُتَخَلِّقًا بِأَخْلَاقِ اللَّهِ. that the Prophet ﷺ, he demonstrated the divine attributes, sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. Not only did he demonstrate those, he demonstrated those to the extent that he was the highest and most complete example of these names and attributes, inwardly and outwardly, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi, such that he said in his sahih, من رآني فقد رأى الحق. If someone has seen me, then he has seen al-haq. And it does not escape any of us, it perhaps doesn't escape any of the children who have been to Muslim school, that al-haq is min asma'illahi al-husna. And scholars such as Ibn Ajiba mention about this, that you could say, من رآني فقد رأى الحق سبحانه. Glory to him. How is that? Meaning, you've seen the vicegerent of al-haq. You've seen the one who demonstrates to you the names and the attributes of the truth, subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have seen the one who demonstrates you the Quran. To the extent that Anas said about the last time in which he saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that Allah's messenger gazed upon us while they were in the prayer, and they were almost tempted away from their prayer by their joy at his being well and his standing on that day of his passing, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. That Allah's messenger gazed upon us and it was as though his face was a page of the Quran. So he came, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi, emerged into this realm in his meaning, his spirit and his body, and in his physical form, much less his character, he demonstrated to us, translated to us, all meanings of beauty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's names and attributes, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. So that is his akhlaq, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. The akhlaq of any of the messengers, the revelation of any of the messengers, of any of the knowers of God, of any of the siddiqeen, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam came and demonstrated that, came and elucidated that, came and reflected that light of the revelation to you and I. فَلَكَ الْحَمْدُ وَلَكَ الشُّكْرُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ. So we ask, we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that. Brothers and sisters, what about my and your character though? What about my and your knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? My and your experience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His names and His attributes. And that's what we're here for. We're here to become virtuous by studying the Prophet of all virtues, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi. And he, Allahumma salli wa sallam wa baraka alayhi wa alayhi, he demonstrated us that path in simple terms, as Shaykh Ibrahim mentioned. And from his mu'jizat is that he was given jawami'ul kalim. So he taught us in another hadith Qudsi, on the authority of Abu Huraira, as Bukhari narrates, من عادى لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب. If someone has enmity towards a wali of mine, someone dear to me and beloved to me, then I declare war upon him. And then the Prophet ﷺ, in this hadith Qudsi, describes to us the path to your and my realization of that state of being beloved to Allah, of truly having noble character, of ultimately being a vicegerent of God on the surface of this earth, as was our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So he said, ما تقرب إلي عبدي بشيء أحب مما أحب إلي مما افترضت عليه. My servant doesn't draw near to me. Who's saying? Allah's saying, my servant does not draw near to me by anything more beloved to me than what I've made an obligation upon him. There's a step on the path. A step on the path of knowing Allah. A step on the path of being like the Messenger of Allah, that we fulfill our obligations. وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ حَتَّى أُحِبَّ. My servant continues to draw nearer to me by voluntary works, by sunnah works, recommended works, additional works, beyond his obligation, expressing his yearning for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's nearness, for nearness to Allah and His Messenger. The servant continues to strive by abundant voluntary works until what? Hatta uhibba, until I love this servant. A beloved servant is like who? He's like the beloved, al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. This servant obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his hearing by listening and hearing in a manner in conformity to the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in its obligations and its recommendations. He obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by emulating the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with his eye in obligations and recommendations, and similarly with his hand, and similarly with his feet in riwayat, and similarly with his heart, and similarly with his intellect, and similarly with his tongue by which he spoke. He emulated the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and brothers and sisters, that is your and my path, quite simply, to being imbued with and embodying the character of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is that we strive in emulation of him. And we follow him with these faculties that Allah gave us, such that Allah makes our faculties like his faculties, sallallahu alaihi wa sahbihi wasallam. So that servant who's beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah described his state, and he said, فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتُهُ. When who loves him? When I love him. When I love this servant. When Allah, the Lord of the heavens and the earth, loves this servant, this creature, this child of Adam, this follower of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How does that servant become? كُنْتُ سَمَّهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِي. That servant becomes a reflection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's action on the surface of this earth. I am the hearing with which he hears. Allah says, I am his hearing. Were Bukhari not to have narrated that, we perhaps could not pronounce that. It might be illegal to pronounce that. A great American scholar, Dr. Omar Farouk, he said that there are two repositories of knowledge, an inward repository and an outward repository, and this is from the inward repository that slipped into the outward. Perhaps because there's a threat about mistreating the awliya. So we need to know that. I am the hearing with which he hears. I am the sight with which he sees. I am the hand with which he grasps. I am the foot with which he walks. When he asks me, I grant him. If he seeks refuge, I will give him. I do not call the angel of death to and fro, is one of the meanings of at-taraddud, which could be translated to hesitate, about anything that I am willing that I will do, that I, as I do in his seizing the soul of this servant, he dislikes death and I dislike saddening him. To the extent that the likes and dislikes of this servant, this vicegerent of God on the surface of this earth, and that's a deep meaning of this tradition, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's as though he wills in conformity to that. But what that is that servant was annihilated such that his will only conformed to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is as Muhammad was, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi. I am the hand with which he grasped. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say about that hand? وَمَا رَمَيْتَ إِذْ رَمَيْتَ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ رَمَى. You didn't throw when you threw, speaking to the Prophet. You didn't throw when you threw, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala threw when he grasped a handful of earth and threw it on the battle of Badr, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. So brothers and sisters, these virtues are not something to which we merely pay lip service. They are not something which is deep and philosophical, though they're deep and beautiful. They're something that is close to you and I, and as love of Allah and His Messenger, as emulation of the Sunnah of His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And with this, we'll close. This khilafa, this vicegerency, it was for Adam on the surface of this earth, not in the heavens. And what was the sabab? What was the causal means that resulted in, that Allah made result in Adam's descending to the earth? It was Adam committing a dhanb, committing a misdeed with respect to his station and messengership. That when Adam committed his misdeed, that was a causal means to his descending to the earth that would be the place where he would be crowned with the crown of khilafa. So what did Adam do? Ala nabiyyina wa alayhi salam. When this matter occurred, and far be it from him that it be a deliberate sin, he didn't have an azam, a resolve to sin, but rather he forgot. But when he committed this misdeed with respect to the station of his khilafah, he made tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was humbled and returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala humbly. So brothers and sisters, do not think that you're attempting to aspire to these meanings means that you're a saint today. Don't think that it means that you're faultless. Don't think that it means that you're sinless. Rather, if you're broken if you're saddened, if you're humiliated, if you're disgraced before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by your own sins, so that you're driven to Him in repentance, in seeking forgiveness, in tawbah, this is your first step towards khilafah. That was the means by which Allah caused Sayyidina Adam to descend. So brothers and sisters, Allah is merciful. Brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent His beloved. Allah just demonstrated through this beloved the path to Himself, so that you and I could know Him, so that you and I could experience Him, so that you and I could demonstrate what He loves on the surface of this earth. And we ask Him, and He's the most merciful of the merciful, to enable us to emulate His beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam in word, in deed, in character, in fard, in sunnah, in our marital relations, in our rearing of our children, in our respect towards elders, mercy towards the young, goodness to neighbors, dawah to non-Muslims, service of humanity, charitable ventures, knowledge, conveyance, honoring the scholars that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has gifted you. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us to know Him and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and emulate Muhammad, and by Muhammad know Him. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us vision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the mir'ah, in the mirror of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Please excuse me.